What's going on, YouTube? It's the KC Sneakerhead coming at you today with my first in a series of videos I'm gonna be bringing you guys. Today, I'm taking a closer look at one of my more favorite pairs of J's that have been released in the last 7 or 8 years. These are the Jordan 12 Rising Suns that originally released November 21st, 2009. This was a limited release pair of J's and the retail price was set at $150 at the time. About 5 years later, the market value on them is about $250, which isn't too terribly steep considering how fresh these shoes are. I picked these shoes up in a local trade and unfortunately didn't get them with the original box. I was actually driving off and I noticed they were sitting in an older Grape 5 box, but that wasn't too much of a hold up. Still a nice little cop all in all. The official colorway of these is white, varsity red, and black, and I have to admit I am a sucker for all white kicks. One thing that I wish was included with the shoe was the limited band insole that released with some of the original Rising Suns, but then again, I cop shoes to wear them, not necessarily to collect them, so the original white insoles aren't something I'm tripping off of. Taking a closer look at the side of the shoe, you see the patent leather with the hits of that reptile skin that we all love on the Jordan 12s. From the toe box all the way up to the heel of the shoe, you've got that mix and match Rising Sun inspired leather pattern with these hits of the perforated leather, which is a super nice touch that we haven't seen too often from the Jordan brand. The back of the shoe has your black and red Jordan patch and your heel tab, which definitely helps set the shoe off, giving it a little bit of touch of some color added to that all white theme. Last but not least, the bottom of the shoe has your same typical Jordan herringbone pattern that you see on all the 12s with the white and the black rubber. Feeling good, feeling great. Lot of twists and turns, but I got my paper straight. On the road to the riches, driving 88. With a couple bad bitches, driving 88. Stunting. Me and my niggas can't wait. We trying to get a meal for every digit on our plate. On the road to the riches, driving 88. With a couple bad bitches, driving 88. Okay, I'm high up, baped out, more swag than the Lil Wayne. Even got no stripes on, but damn, I'm so official. If I ever got some drama, I send.
Thanks again for all the looks, sneakerheads. Don't forget to give the video a like and feel free to subscribe to my channel if you're interested in seeing more of these reviews, pickups, on feets, and eventually even some restoration projects with tips and tricks that you can use to make your beaters turn into heaters. This is the KC Sneakerhead tuning out. From the freak though, I'm just trying to get my cut. Chopper, chopper down. Watch me throw some money up and these bitches hit the ground while I'm stunting.